Mark Rutland is a, quote, Mr. Fix-It for the business world. First, he fixed a mega church that was losing money and members. Then he rescued a school that was struggling to make ends meet. And a few years ago, Mark faced his biggest challenge yet, saving the big Oral Roberts University.
When Dr. Mark Rutland took the job as president of Oral Roberts University, the school was more than $55 million in debt. It was on the verge of shutting down. Now, after a few short years under Rutland's leadership, the university is completely out of debt. Enrollment is up, and the school is thriving once again. ORU was the third organization Dr. Rutland saved from disaster over the past 25 years. Now he shares his secrets of turnaround leadership in his new book, Relaunch, How to Stage an Organizational Comeback.
Well, Mark Rutland is here with us. His book is called Relaunch. It's available where books are sold around the nation, and I'm sure you'll find it very interesting. Let's just introduce our guest right now. Mark, it's good to have you with us.
Great to be back. Thank you.
You took on an enormous challenge at ORU, $55 million debt, a huge program of building. The buildings were in bad condition. The enrollment was falling. I mean, it was a... How come you do that? I mean, you got a death wish or something?
Well, I asked my wife to check and see if there was a sign on my back that I had never seen. No, it was exciting. It was a great challenge. And, of course, we had this wonderful family that stepped in, the Green family. None of it would have been possible without...
That's the Hobby Lobby people.
Hobby Lobby people. Yeah, right. And their largesse was absolutely indispensable in the process. So I don't know at that stage of my life if I would have gone to it. Really, what they needed was leadership.
Right.
And the culture of the university had begun to erode. And so what they needed was management, leadership, and culture. And it seemed like the right challenge. I was 61 when I went there, which I felt young, and I still do.
Well, you look young, but I'm sure that, well, that ages you really substantially.
Well, an adventure is fun, though.
Sure it is. Well, they'd gone through with Richard. They'd fired him, had the board. Did you get a new board for the school as well?
Yes, a totally new board. Yeah. I was concerned about the... Two things that concerned me the most turned out to be the greatest blessing. Mm-hmm. I was concerned about the students. They didn't know me. They had been through a lot. They were challenged in the presidential transition. The student body embraced Allison and me. Mm-hmm. It was a wonderful thing. And the second challenge was the faculty. The faculty had sued the previous president. You know what can happen. You remember the faculty at Harvard basically got the president fired. So I was deeply concerned about that. And that turned out to be a love affair. We just had I probably had a better relationship with the faculty at ORU than any president of any university I know of.
Why'd you take it to start with?
Well, I really struggled with it. They courted me for 6 months.
Yeah.
And I just couldn't see it. It just seemed like a crazy risk at that stage of my life. But I finally came to the conclusion that my comfort zone at Southeastern, where I was, we had turned that university. I'd been there 10 years. I just didn't want my comfort zone to dictate my destiny. And it seemed like another great opportunity. And I thought, you know, I've got one more rodeo. And I went out there, and it just went great.
You went on a fierce bull, but you rode him all the way. You got your 8 seconds.
It was a scary bull. Yeah.
But Mark, what are your principles? What did you do as you went in ABC? What would you advise somebody to do?
The first thing is reality.
Yeah.
No institution, organization, marriage, life, nothing will change until somebody looks in the mirror and says, this can't go on this way. And one of the problems, Pat, is frankly, Christians tend to indulge themselves in magical thinking.
Yeah.
Something will happen. It's not as bad as we think. They get theology mixed up with reality. And so at some point or another, as William Glazer said, you got to have reality therapy.
Okay.
That's where you say, this has got to change. The second thing is that you have to know what has to change. Mm-hmm. There has to be specific analytical, do a systems analysis. And the third thing is for the CEO, the new president, CEO, mm-hmm. whatever that person is, has to see themselves as an active catalytic agent of high octane energy. a startup or a turnaround requires huge personal expenditure of energy. Mm-hmm. And that president is the senior culture officer, senior academic officer, senior economic officer, all of that until the president steps in and says, or leader, CEO, whatever it is, whether it's a hardware store mm-hmm. or a university or a church, that this person has to provide that level of high octane energy output.
There was no detail too small for you to get involved in then.
You've got to be involved in detail. At the same time, you have to not be a micromanager. Hire the right team. You have got to get people around you that can really, really pull it.
Well, was your big deal to get in new people or to motivate the ones that were there?
Yes.
Both.
That's exactly right.
Yeah.
We did have to get new people. I hired new executives. The executive staff, I changed.
You did.
And then, but the faculty, the staff down, needed to be re-motivated. What had happened at ORU was that the dream had been damaged.
Yeah.
And that's what we had to do, was re-articulate a culture of joy. Mm-hmm. There was just a kind of pervasive sadness. And we had to re-energize the joy and re-energize the dream.
I was there in the early days. I was head of the, I think they had something called the President's Council Cabinet or something. I mean, when Oral Roberts was there, and there was huge dream, huge joy, everything. And then it just collapsed.
It imploded, and all the difficulty and the scandal and the lawsuits and all that. So what had to happen was executive leadership that could bring back a sense of confidence. Trust mm-hmm. had to be restored. I spoke to every civic organization in Tulsa, Oklahoma,
yeah, yeah.
And you just have to go and open the books and get them right and get everything right and lead. It's the kind of turnaround, frankly, that I think we're going to need nationally at some point.
Boy, you're not kidding. I mean, at starting with the top and all the way through. How is ORU now? What did you do?
ORU is debt-free.
Come on, debt-free?
Debt-free. We have had also done $57 million worth of deferred maintenance for cash. We built an $11.5 million student center for cash. And we've had four straight years of enrollment growth and four straight years of freshman retention rate over 80%.
Mark, that's extraordinary.
It's a miraculous story. Really, it is.
You will be so much in demand that you forget retirement, man. The offers are coming in over the transom, I bet, right now.
Well, it's very exciting. I'm traveling, speaking, lecturing, consulting.
Yeah.
The book has gone great, the New York Times bestseller list, and so we're very excited about the future.
But you leave tomorrow. ORU is your last day.
Tomorrow's my last day at ORU.
Mark Rutland, God bless you. That's tremendous. I appreciate it. The book's called Relaunch. It's now how to stage an organizational comeback, and this is a man who knows how to do it.